127.6. His opponent 1-0 with a knockout in his debut from Sonora, Mexico, Daniel Cabrera. Cabrera 126.2. He's going to chase over Daniel Cabrera.
So we're here, this is the card of Zapata. Just asked Oscar De La Hoya seconds ago, does he want the winner to fight Tank? And I'll upload that video so you get the answer. You want to weigh in right now? You're gonna.
I'm gonna start punching my chest.
Like a gorilla. Roxy, when you face off, do you push people? Do you slap people? Do you punch them?
Juan Sintano from Managua, Nicaragua, looking for his ninth professional victory against El Terror from Sonora, Mexico, Gael Cabrera, the young super bantamweight, looks to remain perfect inside the ring tomorrow evening. And a big challenge in front of him, the veteran Sintano, taking on the young undefeated Cabrera from La Ciudad Obregón. All right, Pedro, you are standing by with our next one tonight.
So guys, I'm gonna put Roxy on the live. See if Roxy, talk to the people on the live a little bit. See if they're ready. I just jumped on.
You guys have any questions? You guys want to see the weigh-ins? My teammates. And this Elie.
I've been working on his English. You tell me that last week. One question in English. Okay. How do you feel?
I am ready.
You're working on it, Joe. I am ready. All right. Toda gente de Sonora. Que les digo, all the people in Sonora, we have to tell them.
How do you see the comments?
You have to ask them if they have any questions for you.
I don't think they do. They just want to see the weigh-ins.
All right, don't miss this fight. If there's one more three on this show, do not miss my fight tomorrow.
But I don't think I'll make it
wait. All right, Gael Cabrera, you can watch him tomorrow on the Golden Boy YouTube page. Do not miss that young man. 19 years old, and he's ready to put on the show. That Golden Boy YouTube broadcast is going at 3 o'clock, Joe.
Saludos, compadre. Thank you, Beto. Now, five fans, we're ready for our third preliminary
match
on the Golden Boy YouTube channel. Six rounds of super lightweight action. And Krause step up onto the scale from Mexico City, Mexico, Roberto Gomez. His opponent from Mexicali, Baja California, Mexico, Ping Pong Reyes. Roberto Gomez, official weight 140 even, 140. 140 for Gomez.
Looks familiar.
His opponent from Maine County, ladies and gentlemen, here is Ping Pong Reyes! And the undefeated Reyes, 139.6, 139.6, Ping Pong Reyes! Roberto Gomez, 5-1. With five knockouts, all of his wins by KO, takes on undefeated.
Ask history of the decade has gone live. Well, I know you're not talking about me because I'm just holding the phone, but you're still watching, right? You're still watching the live, right? We're giving you a show. Okay, then.
YouTube channel. Six rounds, super lightweights. Gomez contra Reyes.
Él es el capi, era el capi, era el...
No, yo conozco él.
¿Sí lo conoces?
¿Del equipo?
Se capa en el Comité Olímpico.
No, yo conozco la cara de él, como yo vi.
Golden Boy Promotions, next in Independence Weekend here at the Commerce Casino in Commerce, California. Not too far from the downtown LA offices of Golden Boy Promotions. Joined now by Ping Pong Reyes, young man. You got the huaraches on, so you know it's next in Independence Weekend. It seems really good. Representing Westside Boxing, Salcedo Brothers, and also Palmdale, but most importantly, the roots in Mexicali. Ping Pong, what kind of fight are we going to see tonight?
Good morning. Shout out to everybody paying attention. Ready for an extra fight, man. Came to the Mao, that's what we train for. So, double pistols, aquí, el sábado, todos los manes que ataquen a todos. Y más que nada, una guerra de casos, se lo acabo de decir, es una fecha y muy importante para nosotros. Hoy va a ser el grito, todos están ensayando, todos están ensayando la pelea. Así que, saludos a todos. Yo me pongo que va a ser una banda, un fuerte allá. Nosotros, la neta, vamos a levantar el neta, un fuerte de rifle, a Gabriel.
I thought I might get this interview with Ping Pong. You ask him one question, he answers in two languages. Ping Pong, good luck to you. Joe, can you top that? Thank you, Beto. Now, fight fans, we're ready for our final preliminary bout tomorrow. Six rounds of the super featherweight division from Guadalajara, Mexico. Eric Benitez and from Benitez first on the scale. Stand by, Junebug. We'll get to you in just a moment. Stepping up first, ladies and gentlemen, from Guadalajara, Jalisco, Mexico. Here is Idaho, Eric Benitez. 131.6 for Benitez, 131.6. And now here's his undefeated opponent, 6-0 with 5 knockouts, Junebug Daniel Garcia. 132, Daniel Garcia. And in just a moment, we will get a word from Junebug when he stands by with Beto Duran. We remind you, ladies and gentlemen, doors will open at 3 o'clock tomorrow.
Dang.
3:10 is our first fight. If you cannot make it to the venue, please join us online at the Golden Boy YouTube channel.
It's so
early. 5 p.m. on the West Coast. We kick off our live worldwide stream on the zone. The action is
tan temprano.
Catch it all tomorrow, huh? Right here from Compass, California. Beto!
Yeah, but we still got to be there early.
YouTube stream will have 4 fights available for you starting at 3 o'clock Pacific. Myself, Scrappy the Mirror, Sophia Gutierrez will be on the broadcast. And then at 5 o'clock, the zone takes over. Corey Erdman and Jojo Diaz will be on that broadcast night tomorrow evening here from Thomas, California. So if you want to go and follow the Golden Boy social media accounts for all the behind the scenes coverage and a cool feature on El Camarón Cepeda, where he went down to his hometown in San Mateo de Atenco in Mexico, some cool drone videos of that. So make sure you subscribe to the Golden Boy YouTube page for all that information for you. We will be talking with Junebug Garcia.
Grandma
Lulu, great job, and the way your grandson is going, you have to buy some more material. He's 6-0, 5 KOs, Junebug Garcia, good luck to you tomorrow.
Thank you very much.
All right, representing the 303, Jumbug, we'll talk to you tomorrow. You can see him. He's the main event on the Golden Boy.
Thank you, thank you.
Keep going at 3 o'clock. Jumbug,
let the fans know you're going to turn pro soon.
4 o'clock.
Yes.
Jumbug,
oh, yeah. I'm turning pro next month. Stay tuned. I can't say too many details, but soon I will make an announcement.
3. Fly, Eagle, fly, Lamar. Go ahead. All right, the Hall of Famer himself, the executioner, all the same things, Bernard Hopkins. This weekend, we're back here talking with the fighters, Mexican Independence Weekend. It's a special one in the sport of boxing, isn't it? Yes, it's a special one in boxing, especially the ninth of the year, losing out 23, fast food for 24. What a bad part to have and to display what's going to be for 2024. It's a lot of talent that's going to show and come sharing that one. So, B-Hop. You know about fighting on big games. You know about fighting for title. The main event tomorrow, Camarón Cepeda. He's trying to put the 135-pound division on notice. What do you like about that event, man?
It will be a really good set for Saturday. I like everything about it. I like gratitude, first of all. And also the work ethic shows when he goes in and fights every time. And I'm not looking for anything different other than maybe an early stoppage or a sadness.
My arm hurts now, Ellie. I don't know how you do this.
You make your mistakes.
Used to it. We're working hard.
You
tell people where to follow you?
Right,
where they follow Kid Kansas at?
Now you're a partner in Golden Boy Promotions.
When are you fighting, Alan?
All of October. November's coming up.
Same.
This is about closing your strong.
Nice.
Yes. I mean, it's important that you make that statement now. Well, those who say that they're not being recognized or they haven't showed themselves that they're relevant, then it's up to them. It's up to them to lead that statement in 23.
Guys, you want me to stay live or just upload the videos later?
Press conference. Make that statement, go to 2024, and have people's name on your mind, on their mind. And when you do that, you set yourself up to be in the line of conversation. And that conversation, along with your performance and victories, will take you to good places, and that's on top. The Hall of Famer himself, Bernard Hopkins, giving you fighters on the state ready in that gym. You know who's ready? The Mariachi Gallo de Oro, they're ready to put on a show before we get to our number one fighter.
Okay, they're gonna have some mariachi playing, guys. Should I stay live or?
Quite impressive.
hopefully we can wait another year to see that one again. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Eight rounds are the zone opener. This is scheduled in the middleweight division. Let's bring them up. Simon Manson from Cancun, Mexico, takes on the Kansas City, Kansas native, Eric Priest. This fight will start live at 5 p.m. on the West Coast on the zone, our worldwide stream. Again, all brought to you by Golden Boy Promotions. Head online, our sponsor,
right, we're good, we're good.
For all of tomorrow night's fight odds and masculine, it's a mentality. Don't be a man, be the man. First on the scale, let's bring up Simon Manson from Cancun, Mexico. And Vigino, 158.6 official. 158.6 for Manson. His opponent from Kansas City, Kansas, 10-0 with 7 knockouts. Here is Eric Priest. $159.8 for Priest, the undefeated middleweight from Kansas City, Kansas. Golden Boy President Eric Gomez on the stage with us today as well, representing for Golden Boy. This is your DAZN opener tonight at 5 o'clock on the West Coast. Simon Manson, 13-1 with 10 knockouts. The heavy-handed middleweight takes on undefeated Eric Priest of Kansas City. Hey, thanks, Beto. Let's move on, ladies and gentlemen. Eight rounds of a light heavyweight division from Mexico City, Mexico. Here's Ricardo Luna. Bravo! Here's opponent from Houston, Texas, TFT, Dennis Tonga. Once again, Ricardo Tyson Luna. 170.8. Next up, his opponent from Houston, Texas, Darius Fogan. Step on up, Darius. DFJ from Houston, Texas.
What's
up? 170.8. And DFJ has a fan out in the audience already. In just a moment, we'll get a chance to hear from DFG as he makes a trip out to California from Houston, Texas. Both fighters came in 170.8 in an exciting eight-round light heavyweight bout indeed. It's coming up tomorrow on the zone here inside of Commerce Casino. Eight rounds of light heavyweight action at Ricardo Tyson Luna, 25-10 with 16 KOs. Takes on the undefeated 6-0, all six rings by knockout, DFG. Catch him tomorrow. Beto, let's hear from DFG.
Joe did a great job today. Not looking like our first time doing this today, right? Every good time here. There he is. Full jump. It says he's from Houston, Texas, but I think El Paso's claiming him. I think Dallas is claiming him. Corpus, the Rio Grande Valley. How did a kid from Houston end up training in LA?
Well, let's start.
We
got Clean in Texas, too.
Oh, we got Clean, too. All right. Presto, everything, dancing while you're at it. Go ahead.
But there's some amazing people out in LA. I had a good opportunity to go train with them. Talk about experience in the world of talent. And so, not just in Texas, we have a good job.
DFG, what's that name for?
That's the
Destin
Brigade.
Destin Brigade, where'd that come from?
It's just an excited. I've had it since I was 2 hours, 8 hours, and a good time.
So now it's the co-main and then the main event, guys. So we're here, Lil Wayne.
Appreciate that compliment, Beto, and my sentiments are shared with you as well. Now, folks, we're ready for our championship fight. Three of them headed your way, 32 rounds of championship boxing, and the first in the women's minimum weight division for the IBF WBO Minimum Weight World Championship. It's brought to you by Oscar de la Hoya's Golden Boy Promotions and this bout in association with Marg Nation. First up, we will bring the challenger from Guatemala. Here is Maria Santizo! And her opponent from San Jose, Costa Rica, here is the world champion, Yoka Valle! And she is the Maria Santizo, first of this game. 104.2, 104, Bucolos. Santizo, 104.2 official weight for the Guatemala. And here is the Costa Rican world champion, Yoka Valle! 105 pounds for Yoka Valle. The upset market, Lali Barrale, Maria Santizo for Guatemala. Guatemala, 11-3, 6 knockouts, takes on the world champion, defending her title, IBF WBO middleweight champ, Yoka Valle, from San Jose, Costa Rica.
Team Yoka right here, guys. That's her sister. That's her teammates.
Again, our world title bout, 10 rounds, minimum weight division, IBF, and heavy boot strap on the line tomorrow evening. You can catch it on the zone. Brought to you by Golden Boy Promotions, backed by an association with Marv Nation, and guaranteed to be a can't-miss fight tomorrow evening.
Shout out to Matthew Graham. Shout out to Matthew Shop. Game phone. I'll do it again, guys. Hold on, after the win.
IBF WTO minimum weight belt on the line.
Shout out to Matthew Chops. Game farm.
It's good though. We're ready to watch you fight here at the Denver Bells. I'm going to deliver you to them. ¿Qué pelea vamos a hacer ahora? ¿Cómo para el próximo?
Bueno,
voy
a celebrar las
fechas
patrias
de
México.
¡Bravo! 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 How bad do you want to put on a great show now? They're even looking at the good thing that they're giving to the room. The younger you go to the room, just the people there and not a day.
Bueno, es difícil que ahora sea tan bien y que más difícil.
All right, guys, we just have the main event left next.
It's hard to become a champion, it's even harder to stay a champion. That's why we're always working hard with our trainer and everybody else on our team to keep going and keep on that show. But when it's birthday, you're supposed to beat that, but then it's 15. What do you have to say?
Shout out to Matthew Perellas and his son Matthew Chop.
And now we'll move to our co-main event tomorrow, ladies and gentlemen. The WBA Intercontinental Featherweight Championship on the line. 10 rounds. First up, the challenger from Ciudad de Mexico, Mexico, Edwin Pupo Palimare.
Carlos
Cruz. He is the corner from Vancouver, Washington. Here is El Tornado, Victor Morales. Palomares, and now here's the unbeaten champion. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome El Tornado, Victor Morales. 126 for the defending WBA Intercontinental Featherweight champion Victor Morales. He's ready to defend that belt tomorrow evening. 18-0, one draw with 9 wins, coming by knockout against the challenger from Mexico City, Pupo Edwin Palomares. He is 18-4-2 with 9 knockouts to his credit. They will face each other one more time before the leather is put on tomorrow evening. The unbeaten record on the line for the champ. He looks to defend tomorrow. It's a featherweight showdown. Ladies and gentlemen, your partner.
Okay, so now comes the main event.
And Beto standing by to talk to Victor Morales tomorrow night. That fight going down, Beto. I'm excited for the co-main event and, of course, the main event as well. But you take this one.
You should be excited, Joe. It'll be a good co-main tomorrow. Victor Morales, Vancouver, Washington, right across the border, representing all the people in the West, and also representing the roots in Chihuahua over the battle film. Victor! All right, what was that stare down?
Another stare down. You look into the soul of another person, trying to tell you what I have. You know, we're going to go out there and do what we do best.
Your last fight, you know, Oscar said at the press conference yesterday, you knocked out an opponent, you knocked out a Delaware, you opened up some eyes. What are we going to get tomorrow?
Another statement made.
Simple as that.
As simple as that. We're going to go out there and do what we do.
Antonado, Victor Morales, you'll see him tomorrow, Joe. 18-0-1, 9 KOs. Good luck to you, man. There it is, representing Pacific Northwest and Chihuahua, Mexico. Good luck to you, Victor. We'll see more of him. He's a co-main tomorrow on the zone, taking on Edwin Palomares from Mexico City. It's Mexican Independence Weekend, so that means Golden Boy is going to put on the show. And right now, I know all about putting on the show on Mexican Independence Weekend, the one and the only, the Hall of Famer, the CEO and chairman of Golden Boy, Oscar De La Hoya. Oscar, this weekend is special for you. Why? Viva Mexico!
Y arriba San Mateo, atentos, ¿eh?
Yoko Valle, San Piso, that's a fight you're really excited about.
I'm really, really excited about Yoko Valle, the greatest athlete from Costa Rica. She's putting Costa Rica on the map. It's a beautiful country. We're excited about this fight, and tomorrow will be a war.
And in the main event, Francisco Hesta doesn't back down from anybody. He's a tough Filipino fighter who comes to bring it every single time. But Camarón Sabella is going to make him some noise. He signed him a few years ago. He's been knocking people out. This division with Camarón, he's knocking on the door, isn't he? Yeah. The mariachis are ready to go.
Yeah,
it is special. And again, que viva México!
Let's meet our two fighters for tomorrow night's main event. First up, from San Diego, California, here is Mexico, No Mercy, Hesta! And his opponent, hailing from San Mateo, Atenco, Mexico, William, El Camarón Cepeda!
And here's his undefeated foe, 28-0, 24 knockouts, William Zepeda!
Now from the face off, guys.
Y arriba San Mateo, esté con la tierra del calzado, señores.
San Diego up at Commerce today, representing Mercito
and Scott
here, looking to shock the world tomorrow evening as he goes against the undefeated 28-5 veteran, who is perfect with 24 knockouts in Camaro, Lil Cepeda. Both fighters, 134.2. Get your tickets and join us for all the action tomorrow starting at 3 o'clock and to make our way to this main event.
So guys, there you have it. I might end the live here. We'll have all the videos up on EsNews.
Dad, here, you have Marley, you have Marley boxing behind you. All right. I think the woman has your manager and a couple other people on your side. You said you love them, but I'm going.
I kind of like it because there's some pressure about it. And for me, just to show, just go show in the ring. I don't care if it's on the big dog or on the top.
The real deal is the fight time. All right, there's the fight time, you'll take on anybody. You don't back away. Every bum has always said, they call you and you say, yep, what do you know what's going on? Why take on coming out today?
Obviously, Gomez Ojeda is upcoming fighter.
All right, who looked better for you at the weigh-in, at the face-off? Who wins and why? Main event.
Main event.
28-0, 24 knockouts?
I think he's still young, very hungry fighter.
You're good enough. Good.
Jason, who wins the main event? What about Canelo and Charlo? Who do you like?
We know Canelo, people are saying he's on this side a little bit. They always kind of present a bit of trouble with like boxers.
I feel good.
Charlo can box him. I think he's got a chance.
I said it's 50-50.
Yeah, Charlo tried to trade with him and it's Canelo all night long.
So you think he has to box to him?
Yeah, I think Charlo.
You agree?
I agree. I just think Canelo's looking, you know, counterpunching. Lately, how he's been looking, too much counterpunching, looking for one shot. And I think maybe if Charlo's a smarter fighter, even on the inside, you know, he can pull it off. But mainly if he sticks to the outside, it'll be better. It'll just be an easier fight.
You fought Boo Boo?
Yes.
And it looks like he's fighting Benavidez. What do you think of Benavidez Boo Boo?
I mean, Boo Boo's an awkward fighter, but I think Benavidez is just looking too much for him right now. I think he's in his peak right now. He's working hard, and I think Benavidez is off.
I think that these are the opportunities that he deserves. I would like to see Boo Boo get these opportunities after a run of fights. You know, like get one or two fights. But he's so underrated. He's so avoided. I really hope Boo pulls off the win. He deserves it. He deserves a good fight for like Canelo. But Benavidez is badass. That's going to be a very, very good fighter.
Okay, last one. KSI against Conor McGregor.
I don't even know.
Conor McGregor all day long.
Conor McGregor and Jake Paul.
San Mateo Achenko, 20 years.
What about Gervonta Davis and Connor? All right, where do people follow you, Jason? Joel, would they follow you?
Joel, Idiarte, J-O-E-L-I-R-I-R-T-E underscore. And we
just have time,
him.
Just time, bro. Watch out for this play. He's a badass.
The future. There they are. ¿Cómo estás, campeón? ¿Feliz? Muy loco, Carlos? No. Muy inteligente. He's crazier? ¿Por qué?
Same. Together.
Hey, how's your face up? Cara, cara.
He are afraid.
He's ready.
This is the medicine. This is the medicine. It's strong.
Thank you.
Lo que es para México, para México, compa. Viva México, cabrones.
Hey, what about Zepeda and Gervonta? What do you think?
Come on.
Zepeda and Gervonta Davis.
¿Cómo dice que?
Cepeda y Gervonta Davis, ¿a quién le vas?
¿A quién? ¿El camarón o
Gervonta
Davis?
No, Cepeda, Gervonta Davis.
Mira, Cepeda.
Okay.
Viva México, pura medicina, papá.
Thank you, Carlos. Always good to see you. Hey, what do you think about Carlos? What do you think about him? Okay. How many Red Bulls do you have to drink to have energy like Carlos? Diez?
Diez?
He needs 10 Red Bulls. Hey, I just asked him, you against Tank, and he told me that you would win. What do you think? You, him against Tank. Him against Gervonta Davis, next fight, what does he do? Alright, thank you. Last thing, champ, how was the face-off today? Good face-off with Mercedo?
La cara a cara, como con el piso.
Tranquilo, lo que es el deporte, el respeto ante todo, ya la guerra se dará el día de mañana.
I feel good, you know, just respect, first of all, and tomorrow we'll see.
You're a very relaxed guy. How do you have 28 knockouts, 24 knockouts?
Calm guy, and he goes like, I let my talking be done in the ring. That's no need to, you know, be loud and boisterous outside, you know.
All right, who's your favorite fighter all time? Favorito. La historia.
Salvador Sanchez.
All right, thank you. Muchas gracias. No, we're good. Thank you. Alright guys, tune in for the ball, it's gonna be a big day. I'm gonna sign off the live, but we'll be back.
My dad's gonna sing for you.
Okay.
My dad's gonna sing.
Let's go the hallway. Let's go the hallway.